See, we have to learn today comparing the fractions. Which fraction is bigger and smaller? First, we will learn comparing the fraction with equal denominator. Now, you see how denominator is equal. Suppose this is a ribbon strip or your paper strip, and you have made 8 parts of that paper strip, and 2 parts you have colored with pink color, and the 3 parts you have colored with green color. So, which part is bigger here? These are like fraction because this is the 8 parts. No, 8 parts are there. So 2 out of 8 and 3 out of 8. So which fraction is bigger here? 2 out of 8 is bigger or 3 out of 8? This part is bigger. So naturally, what is, we have to put the sign of bigger number or either sign which is opening towards 3 out of 8. So that means 2 upon 8 is smaller than 3 upon 8. Now here what you have to see? You have to see the numerator. If the numerator is bigger, if denominators are same and if numerator is bigger, that means that fraction is the bigger fraction. We have to again learn again a comparison of the fraction when numerators are same. Now before that we have seen when denominators were same. Now we have to see the numerators are same. Okay, so see this fraction, numerators are same means what it is? This paper strip is made into 3 parts. Now you could see 1, 2 and 3. This paper strip is made into 4 parts. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And this paper strip is cut into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts. How many parts are painted here in this paper strip? That is 2 out of 3. That is means 2 parts are painted out of 3. This paper strip, 2 parts are painted out of 4. And these 2 parts are painted out of how many? That is 6 parts. See, same paper strip if you take and make the parts here. So what will happen? The parts is going to become smaller. 2 parts are going to become smaller. These 2 parts are still bigger and these 2 parts are still bigger. You can compare with your Cadbury bar, then compare this with some other things. Okay. If 3 parts are made of that same strip, what will happen? These 2 parts are bigger parts, isn't it? If same strip, if you make how many parts? 4 parts. Then 2 parts will be the small parts. And same strip, if you cut it into 6 parts, what will happen? That 2 parts will be still smaller parts. So what do you mean by that? Which one is more smaller? Which fraction is more smaller? The fraction is having more denominator. Now you see 2 upon 3 is bigger than 2 upon 4, correct? And 2 upon 4 is bigger than 2 upon 6, isn't it? These 2 parts are smaller than these 2 parts. Even though the numerator is same, denominator is different. But who is bigger? Which number is bigger? Where the denominator is smaller. Okay. That means what you have learned now. If the denominators are, if suppose this is a fraction and I have asked you to find out which one is bigger. How are you going to find out? You are going to draw a diagram again? No. You will find out by looking at the numbers. See here. If the denominator is same and you have to see the numerator. That means if the numerator is bigger, that fraction is bigger. Then, now here I have 2 upon 8, 2 upon 9, 2 upon 10. Which fraction is bigger? Numerators are same. Here you will not see numerators. Now you have to see the denominator. The denominator which is very small, that denominator, that fraction is bigger fraction. Which is having smaller denominator. Smaller denominator means you are cutting into still many parts. This is 8. 9 parts if you make, it will become more small. 10 parts if you make, it will become more small. So, when the numerators are same, you have to see the denominator. And when denominators are same, you have to see the numerator. But what is there? When numerator is bigger, that fraction is bigger. Here, denominator is smaller, that fraction is bigger. You have to see the small denominator and that fraction is bigger fraction. Okay? Today we are going to learn now comparing unlike fraction. Last time we have learned comparing like fraction, correct? Now we have to learn comparing unlike fraction. Now what unlike means? Whose numerators, denominators are different. Now suppose this fraction 3 upon 5 and 4 upon 7. Now this fraction is unlike fraction. Okay, why it is unlike? Because the denominators are different. Okay, the denominators are not same. So we have to compare now. Now how to compare here 3 and 4? If you compare the numerator, 4 is bigger here. We cannot compare. If you compare the denominator, 7 is bigger and 5 smaller. We cannot compare. So we have to make the denominators equal. First make the denominators equal and then compare. Let's make the denominator equal. We have to find out in 5's table and 7's table which number is similar. What number comes in 5's table also and 7's table also. So 5 7's are is 35 and 7 5's are is also 35. So what we will do? No, as 5 multiplied by 7 is 35. Okay, so we will make 35 here and 35 here. We have to make like fraction. That means this fraction we will multiply with 5 and this fraction we will multiply by 7. This fraction will multiply by 7 and this fraction we multiply by 5. So let's see 3 into 7 and 5 into 7. Okay. And we have to write the same 4 into 5 and 7 into 5. 3 upon 5 we have multiplied by 7 and 4 upon 5 we have multiplied by 5. So we will get the answer here. 3 7s are 21, 5 7s are 35, 4 5s are 20 and 7 5s are 35. Now according to our rule what we have studied, the bigger numerator. Numerator which is bigger, that fraction is bigger. Okay, so which is bigger fraction? 21 upon 35. Okay, correct? Just a minute. Fraction that is 21 upon 35 is bigger than 20 upon 35. Therefore, 3 upon 5 is bigger than 4 upon 7. You saw what has happened here. 3 upon 5 has come big number than that of 4 upon 7. Okay, what we have to do when there is a confusion like that, when there are unlike terms or unlike fraction, that time we have to make them like fraction and then compare it. Okay. So we have made the like. The value don't change. What has changed? Only the parts has changed. Number of parts have changed. We have made them like fraction. Okay. You have to copy down the same thing in your CW book. Okay. Next we will proceed. From problem set 19. Just I'll show you to solve the ninth sum. Okay. Let's see. Sum number 9 is 5 upon 6 and 1 upon 8. There is a box in between and you have to show which fraction is bigger from these two. So what we have to do in 6's table and 8's table, which is the common multiple that you have to find out. Which is the common multiple? 6 4's are is 24 and 8 3's are is 24. You can take this way also. Or if there is confusion, you can multiply them with each other. Okay. So I'll show you the that way, same way what I have just now. As 6 4s are 24 and 8 3s are 24. Okay, what we are going to do now, while taking this 24 same, we are going to multiply 5 upon 6 by 4 and 1 upon 8 by 3. So let's see, 5 upon 6, 5 into 4 and 6 into 4, and another fraction 1 upon 8, 1 into 3 and 8 into 3. 5 4s are 20 upon 24. 1 3 is 3 upon 24. So which fraction is bigger? 20 upon 24. That means, therefore, 5 upon 6 is bigger than 1 upon 8. Second method, same thing. You have to multiply. 6 8 are 48. 8 6 are 48. You can make 48 48. Okay? And this number also will change. And see what, which fraction is bigger. You will get the same fraction as bigger fraction. Okay? Cut. We have to study today now again the next, that is the same addition of like fraction from the same lesson it is. Okay? Now what addition of like fraction? Like fraction, you are familiar now. Like fraction means whose denominators are same or equal. Okay? So this is a pizza. Okay, this pizza, what has happened? I have made 8 pieces, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 pieces are made of 8, and 2 pieces of these, 2 pieces out of 8, I had it. Okay, and 3 pieces out of 8, my brother ate. Okay. So, how many pieces together are consumed or are eaten? How to find out? Now, you see, it has become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 pieces are eaten. Okay. So, if this thing is not given and you have given only the number. So, what we have to do? 2 upon 8 plus 3 upon 8. What we have added here is, what is added? 2 and 3. Correct? No, we did not add 8. 8 pieces have remained same. Numbers have not changed. This 8 we don't have to add. Otherwise, you will increase more pieces and cut the pizza into more parts. We are not cutting it. What we are doing? We are only adding the numerator. 2 plus 3. We are not adding 8. So, what? While adding, what we have to do? We have to add only the numerator. We don't have to add the denominator. So 2 plus 3 upon 8. It is common for both. Correct? 8 pieces are common for both. So what we have to do? Only add the numerator. So therefore, what it is? 2 plus 3 is 5 upon 8. 5 upon 8, you have got the answer. Okay? Now again, we will not explain you with the help of this. Now you have understood where the fractions are used. Now directly we will add the like fractions. So this from the board also you have to copy down from here. Now in your CW book, we will take one more example. Like fractions I have taken and we have to add them. Now how to add them? It is so easy. That means what you have to do? Only add the numerator. Don't add the denominator. Don't do that mistake. You are not cutting the parts. Only add the numerator. 15 plus 4 upon 20. 15 plus 4 is 19 upon 20. We have got the answer, 19 upon 20. You have to try doing that exercise of addition. Problem set 20, very easy. Only you have to add the numerator, don't add the denominator and do this way. You have to do in this pattern only. Don't do here. Laterally you have to do. And is equal to sign should come under is equal to sign. And numerators, no, this is numerator and denominator you have to separate. Don't write this number like that. Many of them homework I have got, they have written this way. This is not 19 and 20. It is 19 upon 20. You require to put this. Okay. Okay, bye. See you.